morning, Breckenridge Lutheran. Grab a cup of coffee, grab some water, grab your OJ, maybe you even have breakfast. Love to see your pictures if you have any of your family gathering for worship this morning. Grab a quick picture, throw it up on Facebook, tag Breckenridge Lutheran, and we'd love to see how the church is at work today. So sit back and get ready for another a morning of worship with Breckenridge Lutheran and your fellow ministers of the gospel over here at Luthercrest. Good to be with you. Have a great Sunday.
I've got peace like a river. I've got peace like a river. I've got peace like a river in my soul. I've got peace like a river. I've got peace like a river. I've got peace like a river in my soul. You might remember that's from Psalm 46. We begin our worship continuing with Psalms as well, and with our partnership with Luthercrest Ministries. So thankful for them. It's Sunday, November 22nd. I know that so many of us wish, maybe all of us, that we could gather together to care for one another, to be with one another. That's certainly a big fabric part of our faith. Yes, we care for one another. In this time, let's care for one another, although we cannot meet together. We're even alerted now more than ever that it's serious, that coming together is a dangerous thing with COVID. So let's make sure that we care. I have introduced a new Bible study on the Psalms. It is on the network. It's only 2 to 3 minutes long, each one. I invite you to call someone, to do it together with them, maybe with the daily text. Give them a call. Listen to it together. And then share with one another your highs and your lows, your thoughts. I invite you to do so as we care for one another in different kind of ways than we might have. If you're in a Bible study group and you usually met at a certain time, then call each other at that time and care about each other. I welcome you and I hope that you will do just that. If you do it alone, I pray that you will. Use the Psalms as they've always been used, as a psalm book, a prayer book, and a song book. Pray that you will be able to find the kind of solace, the kind of faith, the kind of life and new life in the Psalms that have always been there. Let's join together in doing just that. And then I invite you on Wednesday Eve, Thanksgiving Eve, I'm going to open the church for some private prayer, to come in and light a candle and have a prayer time. I will announce further about that. But please enter through the parking lot. Make sure you're wearing your mask and social distancing, but come in for a sacred time. I'll be here. We'll pray. I'll give a blessing. We'll come in and then we'll exit through the main entrance of the church. That will be Thanksgiving Eve, the night before Thanksgiving Wednesday, 4 o'clock to 6 o'clock. Other announcements then for us. There is Ruby's Pantry. More than ever, people are in need, and we need to respond to them. Monday, November 23rd, 5:15, doors open. Distribution from 6 to 7:30. They need our items. Please bring them. There's a blood drive at Grace Lutheran Church, November 23rd. Be aware of that. And for us, we also want to recognize Russ and Carol Graves in their memory of loved ones for the radio ministry. Thank you for that sponsorship. And for our prayer list, quite a long prayer list. We care for these people. Battling cancer is Lisa, Bob, Bev, Linda, Phil, Paul, Sandy, Steve, Dennis, Scott, Wendy, and Rebekah. And recovering at home, another list. Tina, John, Susie, Ron, Jerry, Janet, Blayne, Laurie, Amelia, Ray, Dave. And give thanks for good health and continuing. Dell and Haedyn, Jill, Royce, Braden, Debbie, Maddie, Casper, Alyssa, Russ, Austin, Eunice, Joan, Deb, and Cliv. And also those that have experienced COVID. Especially we're thinking now of Mel. And Kenzie Christensen, we are continuing our prayer and support for her and for her family as she handles the diagnosis of leukemia. Blessings to her. And for Joel Harms, Maxine and family, as Joel has entered the hospital at Bethany on University. May they all be blessed and may we continue in our prayer and support. I'm giving thanks for some help. Don Young and Lynn Fuder and Roy Marol, they're sharing their time and talents in building the cross that will house the candles for Wednesday Eve. I'm hoping to be able to have that assembled soon so you can see it and join me in giving thanks for this special gift and effort on their behalf. Those are the announcements. Let's turn now to worship with Luther Crest, our friends, and thank God for them. Blessings in your worship with them and with one another. In Jesus' name, amen.
The song is called Blessed Be Your Name.
Blessed be your name in the land that is plentiful, where streams of abundance flow. Blessed be your name. And blessed be your name when I'm found in the desert place, though I walk through the wilderness. Blessed be your name. Every blessing you pour out, turn back to praise. When the darkness closes in, Lord, still I will say, blessed be the name of the Lord. Blessed be your name. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Blessed be your glorious name. Blessed be your name when the sun shining down on me, when the world's all as it should be. Blessed be your name. And blessed be your name on the road marked with suffering, though there's pain in the offering. Blessed be your name. Every blessing you pour out, I'll turn back to praise. When the darkness closes in, Lord, still I will say, blessed be the name of the Lord. Blessed be your name. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Blessed be your glorious name. You give and take away. Lord, blessed be your name. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Blessed be your name. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Blessed be your glorious name. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Blessed be your name. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Blessed be your glorious name.
begin this worship in the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. God of grace and glory, you have come to us once again this day to remind us of your love for us. Through Jesus Christ, who has been raised from the cross, one God, we give the glory. You remind us each and every day that we are your people. But in being your people, we do some wrong things every once in a while, and we need to acknowledge those things that we do, and then humbly confess that we are sorry for these things. And how quickly we confess, God reminds us of God's work in this world through Jesus, not being on that cross. That inspires us to be faithful people and to live a life of love and forgiveness, and then encouraging us to go and do the same. So today, we live in that love. We live in that forgiveness to go out and do God's work today. And it's in God's name we pray. And we all say, Amen. Let us pray. O God of power and might, your Son shows us the way of service. In him we inherit the riches of your grace. Give us the wisdom to know what is right and the strength to serve the world you have made. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
Till I am a soul on fire, Lord, restore. heart. I'm running for your heart till I am a soul on fire. Lord, I'm longing for your wings. I'm waiting for the day when I am a soul on fire. Till I am a soul on fire.
A reading from Ephesians 1:15 through 23. I have heard of your faith in the Lord Jesus and your love towards all the saints, and for this reason I do not cease to give thanks for you as I remember you in my prayers. I pray that the God of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of glory, may give you a spirit of wisdom and revelation as you come to know him, so that with the eyes of your heart enlightened, you may know what is the hope to which he has called you, what are the riches of his glorious inheritance among the saints, and what is the immeasurable greatness of his power for us who believe, according to the working of his great power. God put this power to work in Christ when he raised him from the dead and seated him at the right hand of the heavenly places, far above all rule and authority and power and dominion, and above every name that is named, not only in this age but also in the age to come. And he has put all things under his feet and has made him the head over all things for the church, which is his body, the fullness of him who fills all in all. The word of the Lord. The Gospel according to Matthew, the 25th chapter, verses 31 through 46. When the Son of Man comes in his glory, and all the angels with him, then he will sit on the throne of his glory. All the nations will be gathered before him, and he will separate people from one another, as a shepherd separates the sheep from his goats. And he will put the sheep on his right hand, and the goats at the left. Then the king will say to those at his right hand, Come, you that are blessed by my Father, inherit the kingdom prepared for you from the foundation of the world. For I was hungry, and you gave me food. I was thirsty, and you gave me something to drink. I was a stranger, and you welcomed me. I was naked, and you gave me clothing. I was sick, and you took care of me. I was in prison, and you visited me. Then the righteous will answer him, Lord, when was it that we saw you hungry and gave you food, or thirsty and gave you something to drink? And when was it that we saw you a stranger and welcomed you, or naked and gave you clothing? And when was it that we saw you sick or in prison and visited you? And the king will answer them, Truly I tell you, just as you did it to one of the least of these who are members of my family, you did it to me. Then he will say to those at his left hand, You that are accursed, depart from me into the eternal fire prepared for the devil and his angels. For I was hungry, and you gave me no food. I was thirsty, and you gave me nothing to drink. I was a stranger, and you did not welcome me. Naked, and you did not give me clothing. Sick, and in prison, and you did not visit me. Then they also will answer, Lord, when was it that we saw you hungry or thirsty or a stranger or naked or sick or in prison and did not take care of you? Then he will answer them, Truly I tell you, just as you did not do it to the one of the least of these, you did not do it to me. And these will go away into eternal punishment, but the righteous to eternal life. The Gospel of the Lord.
Grace and peace to you from our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Amen. Well, good morning, church, and hope all is well. I'm doing as good as can be over here in Alexandria, Minnesota, coming to you from my office in the dining hall here on the shores of Lake Carlos at Luther Crest Bible Camp. Glad to be with you today for worship. Having heard our gospel text, how does that make you feel? I wake up each morning wondering, what's the next bit of news that's going to be coming out? Whether that be on the local news or from Fargo or from the Twin Cities, or whether that's the Today Show, or whether that's on Fox, or whether I get it from our local newspaper or the Star Trib, or whether we hear it from our own social media or the conversations we have or other newspapers. How am I going to feel after that news is given? Well, today we are bombarded by many different ways that we get our information. And in today's world, there is enough out there for us to make some good decisions and to have some good understandings about what life is to be like and how we are to interact with one another. I'm reminded after listening to this text today from our gospel that, boy, back in Jesus's times, there was a lot going on also about how we are people, or how we're viewed as people in God's eyes compared to how we're viewed as people in our neighbor's eyes. And I think today, and we've said this before, that boy, to be neighborly certainly has a different context during this pandemic than it has before. But being the neighbor is still drastically important. So let's dive into being that neighbor. We've been embarking here at Breckenridge Lutheran on a Sunday school and confirmation program over the course of the last 10 weeks, where we've been exploring different pieces of how God's call to us is to live out God's love. It is the message of being neighborly. It's understanding that God loves us and holds us, guides us, gathers us, but then we are asked to go out and almost do the same. How we are to be those lights. How we are to be those loves to our neighbors. And I can't but think about the many ways that our local governments, whether that's in North Dakota or Minnesota or wherever you may be, how our local governments have really enacted a decree to be more neighborly to one another. And I was just reading this morning that the supply line is well established, but there are a number of shelves that are bare right now with products. How is that being neighborly? I'm reminded of the ways that the job market has been. You know, at the height of what we thought was the pandemic back in March and April, unemployment was really high. Now it's down in the sevens, still high, but drastically different, and probably will be changing as we look at what this weekend before Thanksgiving bring. How are we to be neighborly there? Or some of the decrees of our local and state and federal government to mask up, to socially distance, to be aware. If you're ill, stay home, or stay home if you don't have to go anywhere. How is our response to this global pandemic neighborly? I'm even going to say that the way that our news comes out, and how it's either classified as good or bad, true or false. How is this being neighborly? I believe that we all now knowing who Jesus is and our efforts here on earth not making much of a situation for our salvation or being with God or being God in heaven or being with God in heaven, that is taken care of. But here on earth, that's a different story. And so as we heard in our gospel text, those convictions were laid out for us. Jesus was pretty focused on what the difference is here in this world. And I think that that is the message for today. What is the difference in this world in this time? As you can see, probably behind me through the reflection of the glass, that the sun is rising once again. That in this world, in this time, the sun rises and the sun sets. And that will continue on into eternity. We know not when that will stop. But as I think about my day ahead, what are the elements that I will embark on that will be true to God's love in this world? Will it be continuing to work on this worship service? Will it be to lift up Luthercrest's work in this world and to invite folks to be a part of it? Will it be to care for a neighbor who is in need? How will I embark God's love on this world? And I think that is the daily mentality that we have to have when we wake up in the morning as people of God. What is our role in God's work today? For we know that in this text from the gospel is that we know when we do something for the least of these, is what Jesus said, is that we are doing it on God's behalf. And that leads to good, not only good feelings within our own hearts, but it's also collectively as we understand who we are in God's community. But if we don't do that, then that feeling has been lost on us. And that changes how we interact with one another. I'm reminded here in the local area, we have a pretty active Helping Hands organization where needs are put out and people respond to help out within seconds, if not 30 seconds. There is someone there to help. And I think that is something that is taking place throughout our land. When we are sick, our systems, or we have systems, we have neighbors in place that are ready to help out when you need it. When you are hungry, there are places to get food. When you are needing some new clothing, there are places ready to assist. We as people have set up this system to take care of one another. And through this pandemic, that system has been challenged, and specifically that system has been challenged within our own minds. I know I have been challenged in trying to figure out what is my new role here in this world, in this local context, in the eyes of Luthercrest, where we're not able to do the things that we normally have done to serve God's people. We're having to restructure, rethink. And I know you probably have also. How do we do life differently? Well, we know that we are firm in our belief that God's got us, God's taking a hold of us, that God is encouraging you and me to reach out to our neighbors, as Pastor Phil has said over the last couple of weeks in the psalm, is reach out to one another, give a phone call, set up a Zoom, do a FaceTime, and connect with people, because that hasn't been lost. While we're not maybe in person with one another very often these days, it still is a possibility for us to connect. And that's what God wants. God wants us to connect, because God's work only takes place when God inspires us to follow God's work. I mean, it's pretty simple. It's not rocket science, even though we just had a rocket go to the International Space Station. What an incredible step. This isn't rocket science. It is God's science. It's God's work. It's God's doing in us what needs to be done. So as we prepare for this week, boy, my eyes are getting caught. There's a huge bald eagle flying over Lake Carlos right now, right on the edge. Another unique joy that we get to see every once in a while. But as we prepare for Thanksgiving, we're being asked to do things differently. So be a neighbor, be a family member, and do the right thing. Reach out, clothe the naked, feed the hungry, visit the imprisoned, help heal the sick, mask up, socially distant, and if you're not feeling well, don't put yourself in environments that could spread this pandemic disease. And I've been pretty fortunate to be in this place here in West Central Minnesota, surrounded by a great cloud of witnesses, surrounded by a mission to inspire faith, stewardship, and community in God's creation. And I invite you today to continue to follow God's invitation to be God's people in this world, to live in love as God has loved us. Let's pray. Gracious God, we give you thanks this day that you've called us together to worship you in this unique environment, and that you've strengthened us to do your work here in this world. God, as your holy scriptures continue to inspire us through that feeling of conviction, please continue to walk with us and encourage us and give us the strength and understanding to do your work in this world. God, we know you've got each one of us in your hands. You're providing healing for those who need it. You're providing guidance for those who are lost. You're providing inspiration for those who need hope. Lord, we ask that you be with us once again today. And it's in your Son's name we pray. And we all say, Amen. God's peace be with you all.
Join us in singing Messiah. Someone shouting from the desert, someone shouting from the sea, someone shouting from the mountains, someone shouting from the valley, Messiah, come and be our King, Messiah.
Greetings, people of Breck Lutheran and the Breckenridge, Minnesota area and beyond. So glad that you've joined us for worship today. Our church is doing work in our local communities. We had a wonderful meatball dinner. We've had some great Sunday school and faith formation activities. Pastor Phil has been inspiring us each and day, every day on Facebook. Through the walk through the Psalms. Pastor Phil has provided some good guidance for us for navigating this time, not only during COVID, but the transition from Pastor Mark and his work to the next pastor that's coming here in the next, 3 to 6 months. I don't know if that's a prophecy or not, but we'll see. But a lot of good work is happening here at the church. And your church needs your support. So as we go through this Thanksgiving season and into the Advent season, we know we won't be gathering in person, but know that the church is still at work. And that your dollars that you can give to support the mission of Breckenridge Lutheran is a gift of gratitude, and it will be welcomed and appreciated. So send your gift in today to the church office as we prepare for the coming months here. Also, we want to give thanks for all the people who participate in the work of the church, from our volunteers to Laurie in our office, to the council and the committee members who are making things happen. That is the church at work. And so we ask for your support today as you go about your days. Remember, Breckenridge Lutheran, and we thank you for being a part of this family.
Longing for Christ's reign to come among us, we pray for the outpouring of God's power on the church, the world, and all in need. Sovereign of all, train our ears to hear your cry and the needs of those around us. Bless all social ministries of the church through which we seek to serve others as we ourselves have been served. Hear us, O God, your mercy is great. You cause rain to fall on the just and unjust alike. Direct our use of creation to provide for the people's needs in ways that are sustainable for the earth. Hear us, O God, your mercy is great. Bring peace to every place where conflict rages. Grant opportunities for ending divisions among us and usher in your reign of unity and reconciliation. Hear us, O God, your mercy is great. Healing the sinful divisions we erect between ourselves and release us from systems of oppression and prejudice. Restore our capacity to see your image in those whose dignity we have stripped away. Hear us, O God, your mercy is great. Pour out the gifts of your Spirit on children and youth throughout the church. Sustain those who work in children's ministry, youth ministry, campus ministry as they nurture the gifts of young people. Hear us, O God. Your mercy is great. Thank you for the saints now departed, who fed the hungry, clothed the naked, and tended to the sick. Guide the hearts and minds and hands and feet of healthcare workers all over this land as we work through this pandemic. Guide us as individuals, as neighbors, to use your love and grace to interact with one another. Inspire us by all of the saints and their example, that we may see your presence in those in need around us. Hear us, O God. Your mercy is great. Receive our prayers in the name of Jesus Christ, our Savior, until the day when you gather all creation around your throne, where you will reign forever and ever. Amen. Let us pray our Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
This song is called Everlasting Love.
Your everlasting love is higher, higher, higher than the sky. Your everlasting love is higher, higher, higher than the skies, higher than the skies. All the wonders of your everlasting love is higher than the ooh, ooh, ooh. Everlasting love is deeper, deeper, deeper than the seas, deeper than the seas. Oh, the wonders of your everlasting love is deeper than the ooh, 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 ooh. Your everlasting love is reaching, reaching, reaching out to me. Your everlasting love is reaching out to me, reaching out to me. Oh, the wonders of your everlasting love is reaching out to me. Ooh, 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 ooh. Your everlasting love is higher, deeper, reaching out to me. Your everlasting love is higher, deeper, reaching out to me, reaching out to me.
May the God of all creation, in whose image we are made, who claims us and calls us beloved, who strengthens us for service, who gives you reason to rejoice and be glad, the blessing of God, Sovereign, Savior, Spirit, be with you today and always. Amen.
The holidays are right around the corner, and time seems to go faster every year. This year, don't panic about baking, and let Luthercrest do it for you and take away some of that stress. Luthercrest has a variety of home-baked popular cookies, breads, candies, and pies to choose from. That way, you have more time to do other things. More information on how to order your cookies and other baked goods from Luthercrest, visit luthercrest.org and get your order form today.
Merry